Alrighty. What's going on, guys? It is your boy Mars, and today I got a car here that was requested. It is the 1970 Chevelle. I just finished buying it, so we're gonna end up tuning this car from scratch. So I'm gonna show you guys all the parts that I'm gonna put into it, and let's get right to it. Let's go to the garage, let's go to upgrade, let's go to custom upgrade, and the custom upgrade, let's go to the conversions, go to engine swap. We're gonna leave the stock motor in this car, and because the other motors is a V12 and a V10, so we don't want that. So we're gonna leave the stock motor. Car is of course gonna be rear wheel drive, and then we are going to put the supercharger in. Let's give it as much horsepower as we can. So as you guys know, with the supercharger, the car is gonna tend to full power, full torque from the line, so it's gonna probably spin on top end a lot more than the turbo. Since with the turbo, it'll have probably a lag, but since it has supercharger, there is absolutely no lag. It's gonna be straight power to the rear tires. So right now what I'm doing is I'm putting everything race on the car. I'm all the way up to the supercharger. Let's put the supercharger race. Let's put the race intercooler. Now let's go to the oil and cooling, and we are at a whopping 1029 horsepower with a torque of 977. So we are not going to put the race oil and cooling. It's only a difference, not that big of a difference, like 6 horsepower difference, but it gives you a lot of weight, so we're not going to put it. We're going to leave it stock. And then with the flywheel, let's leave the flywheel stock. And now let's go to the platform. On the platform, let's of course going to put the race brakes. We're going to put rally suspension. We need it soft. We need the soft suspension so we can pull that horsepower from the front of the car all the way to the rear of the car. So we want that suspension to be soft. And now we definitely need a roll cage. And we definitely need a weight reductor car. So the car right now is sitting at 3,200 pounds. So it's still a heavy monster, but with the horsepower, it should compensate, and it should be a pretty good, cool car to tune for the drag quarter mile. Now let's go to the, let's put everything on here, race as well. For the drivetrain, let's end up putting everything on here, race. And then now let's go to the tires on the front tires. Well, let's first put race tires. We're going to put these race tires on there. On the front tire width, there are only two 15, so we're going to leave it alone. And then on the rears, it is 345s, perfect size tires. You know, of course, you always want to go bigger, but 345s are pretty, pretty good for the rear wheel drive scene. So now let's see what rims to put. Let's put some, of course, you know, guys know me by now, I'm gonna put the lightest wheels, one of the most popular wheels. We're gonna put the hole shots onto the car, and with the rim size, we're gonna leave that alone. As you guys can see, it's 14 in the front and 14 in the rear. Now with the bumpers, let's see what they got. Nothing. Well, I'm not gonna put that on the bumper. And on the rear, let's see, I'm not sure if I should do it or not. Let's not even do it. But I am going to put the hood, one even lighter. So I'm gonna put this hood right there. It's pretty cool looking hood. And that'll be it with the setup of the car. Now let's fully put that installed onto the car, and let's take it to the train tracks. This time let's take it to the train tracks. Well, since we're gonna do this tune from scratch, let's go to the airport, and then we'll do another a pass on the train tracks. So I'm going to show you guys a pass on the airport and a pass on the train tracks. Let's see if it's not raining.
Hey, Flash.
Oh, we got a There's another driver gorgeous weather.
Perfect for your lineup.
Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous weather. Let's go all the way here and let's fast travel to the airport. Great looking car. I do like how it has the stripes. Can never go wrong with a Chevelle. Now, let's see how the car is, if it's going to be a little tricky one since it has a supercharger or it's not. Let's see how it reacts with this kind of motor, with it, the original motor that comes in the car. Since it's not a 6.2. There we go. It's not the 6.2 LS motor. Ooh, hear that motor. Wow, that motor sounds really nice. Really, really deep sounding. Let's go to the settings, and my settings, let's go to difficulty. Got everything turned off pretty much. Car is manual with clutch. If you guys don't know how to use manual clutch, I suggest you guys should start practicing. Besides that, let's go to the cartoon. On the cartoon, we want the tires to be 15 and 15, so the car is going to have a bigger footprint. Now, with this, I'm going to put it at the 2.2, but I don't know how the car is going to react to that. And I'll be back to that later on. Now we're going to put this at the 7, and then we're going to put these two at 65-65. So, yeah, pretty much these tunes are basic tunes. If you guys can always tweak them the way you guys want them, or you guys can, if you have any suggestions with any things to do on the tune, you guys could do it on your own. It's just to help the beginners and to help the community get bigger with the drag racing scene. And yeah, pretty excited for Forza 7. It's coming out the ending of this year, and that's going to be a nice one. That one's going to be really in depth with tuning with that car. With that Forza motorsports cars, motorsports games, usually it's more in depth when it comes to tuning, more realistic. So right now I have the dampening 2 in the front, 10 in the rear. I want the car to initially lift up. Got it at 164 with the springs, and then I got it at 624 in the rear. Got the car raised all the way up at 12 and 12. There we go, nothing with the brakes and the differential. Let's put it at 100 and 100. There we go. Now let's figure out what gear is going to be my gear. Now to launch the car, you're going to press A, which is the e-brake. And then you're going to feather the gas with the RT button, which is the gas button, until the car holds exactly at 2000 on this car. Then you're going to let go of the e-brake. And alrighty, as you guys saw, the car just spin on me. So what I'm gonna do is, hold on, let me do a second gear launch and then see what happens with that. Car sounds amazing. All right, so it hooked second gear, so that means that my first gear was too long, and I'm gonna put my first gear between first and second gear. So I'm gonna put it like right at 2.6. See what the car does now. Launch it again on first gear. There you go, so the car is launching right there. Alrighty, so I can probably put it even longer since the car did not even spin at me at all. I wanted to put it on that braking point. I wanted to like kind of want to spin but not really spin. I'll show you guys what it sounds like and what it looks like. Let's see if I can get it to do that. Okay, so right there is gripping like nothing. Let me keep on. Let me go back. I was only off by a couple clicks, by like, probably like 5 clicks from the original number. Not bad. It's a heavy boat, as you guys can kind of hear it. From the way it's transitioning from gear to gear, it just feels heavy with the car. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just kind of play around with the gears right now, and then I'm gonna figure out what it feels like and what it transitions. So A on the e-brake, feather the gas when the car holds at 2000, let go of the e-brake. Nice. Alright, so that's pretty much good right there with the rest of the gears. I have third gear redlining at 160, which is an ideal quarter mile number. And then I have the second gear, as you guys can see, when it transitioned to that second gear, it was about 6,000. And then when I transitioned to third gear, it was about 6,000. That's kind of what you want. You want the transitions to not be too long. All right, so what I just did is I made it even shorter. I want the car to spin on me. I want to see what it does. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. So I finally got the car to spin. So I know now that the number that it wants is going to be right there. So this is going to be pretty much the tune, guys. Let me fix the rest of the gears. Let me go to 1.4. And then let me go to that. And no 6 gear. Let me just leave it at a 5 gear tune. Okay, so I saved that. Let's go back to it. Let me show you guys real quick. So the car is going to be at the 2.80, and then second gear at 2.05, and third gear 1.60. That's pretty much going to be the tune for the quarter mile. And let me set the destination. As you guys already know, 440 yards, it's going to be 1320 feet, which that is a quarter mile. So let's get to that 440 yards. There we go. Now we're going to press e-brake, feather the gas into the car. Feather into the car holds at 2000, gas all the way down, e-brake all the way down, let go of the e-brake. Full gas it all the way. Oh, look, we're right at 6000. 6000 again. Perfect pass with this car. With the numbers, it seems like this car is kind of slow since it's so heavy, but it's a really nice car. The way it transitioned, the way it drives, the way it even sounds, it's really good. Hope you guys like the tune on this car. It's a really nice car, and original Chevelles are really nice. And hope you guys like it. Like always, subscribe, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys around with another tuning video. Alrighty guys, peace out.